So President Trump desperately trying to change the conversation with just 5 days to go until Election Day. He's doing it again tonight. Yet another rally, trying to get you talking about a non-existent crisis at our southern border. Non-existent. But he really upped the ante earlier today at the White House. Here's what we were told. We were told the president was making a major policy announcement on immigration. He didn't. He didn't offer any details about his the promised executive order, just that his administration is finalizing a plan. He didn't get into any specifics at all. All he did was recycle the same old fear-mongering and lies. Crisis on the border, right? Fear, invasion, scary, criminals, tough people, drugs. It's the same old toxic brew of misinformation and flat out lies that we have heard in every one of his rallies. He even threatened that troops at the border, you heard Chris just say it, troops at the border, could fire on anyone in the migrant caravan who throws a stone, throws a rock. One of our distinguished military veterans could hardly believe his ears when he heard that. And we're gonna talk to him about that tonight in just moments. All that while this disgusting race-baiting video is still pinned to the very top of Trump's Twitter feed. It's obvious. Here's the truth. The president wants you to be terrified about immigration. He wants you to be afraid of migrants hundreds of miles away from our southern border, hundreds of miles away. They won't be here by Election Day or anytime soon after that. They may never even get close to this country. That's what he wants you to talk about. He wants you to talk about now for the next 5 days to go until this election. Why does he want that? Think about it. Why does he want it so badly that he'd revel in these kinds of tactics? Maybe because, all right, here's what he doesn't want you to talk about. He doesn't want you to talk about allegations of voter suppression across this country. Okay, Georgia first. In Georgia, where the Republican candidate for governor's name is Brian Kemp. By the way, he's also the Secretary of the State, so he's in charge of the election. He faces backlash and lawsuits after the Associated Press reported that his office suspended more than 53,000 voter applications. Guess what? Almost 70% of them were African Americans. His office, Kemp's office, maintains that those people will be allowed to vote, but only if they bring the proper ID. So now let's go to North Dakota. It's new requirement there that Native Americans, that they have to show specific forms of photo ID bearing their street address. Okay, but here's the hitch. The problem is there are few actual street names on reservations. See what they're doing there, they did there? Dodge City, Kansas. A judge tonight denied the ACLU's request, denied it, to open a second polling place or return to the original one after officials moved it out of town. They just moved it right out of town. Here's what they claimed. They said that the old site was inaccessible because of construction. Here's a hat tip to my colleague, Rachel Maddow. Rachel sent a producer there who found that the old site not blocked by construction. Not at all. In fact, there are numerous events scheduled there. So yeah, the president doesn't want you to talk about any of that. He doesn't want you to talk about the deficit skyrocketing. An increase of $113 billion. You know why? It's mostly due to this president's tax cut for corporations in the 1%. He doesn't want you to talk about the stock market. Have you seen your 401k lately? The stock market just had its worst month since 2011. He doesn't want you to talk about his empty promises of a 10% tax cut that he made recently for the middle class, one he promised to pass before the election, even though Congress is not in session, was not in session. Remember when he busted that claim out of nowhere and everyone was like, what are you talking about? Would it surprise you to hear that the president, after trumpeting the fake tax cut, quietly conceded today that there's no chance it's going to happen this year? The president who said this yesterday.
I always want to tell the truth. When I can, I tell the truth.
Who said that yesterday has been telling lies about protecting pre-existing conditions. That's another thing he doesn't want you to talk about at all. And his administration admitted it last night because they told Jim Acosta, the president's immigration rhetoric is, quote, clearly working. We are all talking about it and not health care. He doesn't want you to talk about his empty promises to preserve coverage of pre-existing conditions while his administration simultaneously works to kill the Affordable Care Act, a.k.a. Obamacare, which protects pre-existing conditions, right? He doesn't want you to talk about how he palled around with the repressive Saudi regime responsible for the death, the brutal death of Jamal Khashoggi, and went along with their ridiculous cover stories. He doesn't want you to talk about his own fear-mongering rhetoric as Pittsburgh is still bearing victims of the worst anti-Semitic attack in this nation's history. And as investigators are building their case against a Trump supporter charged with mailing pipe bombs to this network and prominent Democrats across the country. This is what he said tonight.
We did have two maniacs stop a momentum that was incredible because for 7 days, nobody talked about the elections. It stopped a tremendous momentum.
So let me ask you to do just a little thought experiment with me, okay? Are you ready? If the man who sent 15 bombs in the mail was a deranged Hillary Clinton supporter, what would the president be saying? If the man who shot and killed elderly Jewish people praying in the synagogue had been an illegal immigrant or a Muslim, imagine what we would be hearing from Donald Trump, and imagine what we'd be hearing from right-wing media. Oh my gosh, the world is ending. Heads would be popping off everywhere. He wants Americans to hear the caravan more than the four white supremacists in Southern California indicted just today for carrying out violent attacks at political rallies. Did you hear about that one? He hasn't talked about that. And he definitely doesn't want you to talk about the Russia investigation, especially as emails surfaced today between Roger Stone and Steve Bannon about WikiLeaks, the disclosures of emails stolen by the Russians. That's amid reports that Stone pitched himself to the Trump campaign as a WikiLeaks pipeline. The president doesn't want you to talk about any of that. He has a record that he could run on. The economy is good, despite the deficit in the stock market, as I said, despite those things. He's established a conservative judiciary for a generation. Now, that is a real accomplishment. He has lived up to a number of his promises, and a lot of people don't like that, but it really is true. He talks about those things, but primarily, he is using fear and hate to motivate his base in the days before the midterms. So the president has had a lot to say about immigration. A lot of it is false. A lot of it is racist. A lot of it's mean-spirited. But no matter what the president says, the voters are already voting, already deciding. A lot of them support the president. No one will forget that and forget the lesson of the 2016 election. And a lot of them don't, though. We will know how many and who wins 5 nights from tonight when election officials around the country are counting the votes. Whatever side you're on, whatever side, voting is a right and it's a privilege simultaneously. It's a right and a privilege. It is a right a lot of people didn't have that others fought and died for. That's why we've talked about so much on this show about voter suppression. And we'll continue to do so. It is because your vote really is your voice. That is how this country works. I'm not the only one saying it either.
For anybody here who has an ancestor who didn't have the right to vote, and you are choosing not to vote wherever you are in this state, in this country, you are dishonoring your family. So honor your legacy. Honor your legacy. Honor your right to citizenship in this, which is the greatest country in the world.
An ancestor who didn't have a right to vote here. Count the number of jelly beans in the jar. How many jelly beans are in the jar? Poll taxes. I'm one of them. I'm sure a lot of you at home are. A lot of people fought and died for the right to vote. The least you can do is honor them by going out to vote.